What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? It's me, Mikey Pipes, on our way to a service call in Woodmere at a condo development where their second floor air conditioning isn't working. I think it's the original one with the development, which puts it north of 30 years of age. It's a Lennox. All right, so let's go see what's going on. Stay tuned, pull up your pants, put your boots on, and enjoy the ride. Let's get going.
Oh, we're going to learn some Spanish. Yes. She teaches Spanish. She may be smart at Spanish, but I don't know if she can open the door. Is Lenny here? No? You're welcome.
The heat.
How do you say the door's broken?
Está roto.
Está roto.
There it is.
La puerta
so,
está
¿qué quieres hacer esta noche?
Esta noche voy a cocinar. No.
Venga. ¿Cómo te llamas?
She's talking bad about me?
Yeah, you should. Yeah, you don't even want to know.
I don't, that's why I don't know Spanish.
No hablo, no hablo inglés, a español?
I have trouble with
English. Un poquito inglés. Un poquito inglés.
Un poquito de inglés,
¿verdad? How do you say the air conditioning is broken?
El aire está roto. El aire está...
So, está roto is broken.
Broken.
I take that as broken. So.
Okay.
Vamos no mucho frío. No bueno aquí.
And now I open the windows because it's I like my air conditioned from nature. But Shabbos, when it was very hot...
Shabbos and Sunday.
When it's the heat upstairs... You
could put it like a mom's or
you could request of the thermostat 72 and it can't get it below 79 by the end of the day.
So no bueno aquí.
And, yeah, but that's but
so Masberg told me call Diak because he's good with the air conditioning. So next
there
day I called you.
But it's like there should be a way where you could can get certain look.
Okay.
If it's 100% humidity and 95 degrees out there, you're not delivering anything above 78 or 80. It's physically above.
Here's a good analogy. Either it works or it doesn't.
Yeah.
That's it.
Okay. Orajo, right?
Or downstairs.
Roto.
Downstairs.
Roto.
Zone one. Downstairs works fine.
Okay, so the second floor is the issue.
All right,
let's go to the thermostat.
Let's
go to the thermostat.
The longest day of the year is of this... The sun hits the thermostat very quickly and then disappears.
So let's see what you got. So the thermostat right now is off. We'll put it to cool. It's 74. We'll set it to 70. Let's go see what happens.
No,
I'm waiting for the click, on. Though.
Hold. No, that's what we do. We push the 70 hold. I don't program
it. I didn't hear a click, though.
I don't have the patience for it.
It's that one.
Huh?
Let's turn off the first floor thermostat.
Well, it is off.
All right, I just want to make sure. Is this the first floor?
That's the first floor. You remember that? The faucet and so on? Beautiful car.
Oh, yeah, very nice. Very nice. Let's see what we got. 410A or R22?
R22. Is it true, Mike, that there is a degree of wiggle room where if this is a 2-ton unit, you could swap it for a 2.5 or that doesn't work?
Depends on what the evaporator coil can handle.
Because we'll go downstairs to the basement. Yeah. I'll show you the
Peter, let's grab the tool bag and the R22 gauges. Yep. Low. R22, let's take a look at the coil. Looks pretty decent here. Let's see if we can see over here. Yeah, she's wearing a fur coat.
Is that explains
that my head pressure. Let's see if we see here. More of the same. Fur coat. All right. So the starters,
We need to make sure and verify that the filter is clean and we have good airflow. We'll check that. The coil, I have to disassemble this unit to clean it properly.
Disassemble.
And then disassemble, properly clean it, and then put it back together. Right. And that's just to get it to specifications of coil, of coil condition. But the biggest issue here is the lack of proper refrigerant. You need Freon. Freon's expensive, and you're gonna go through several pounds of it. Even though it's a two-ton system, you're still gonna have several pounds we have to add to this thing. And Freon isn't being manufactured anymore. It's phased out completely, and it's not cheap. We're north of $225 a pound, and you need several pounds of it on top of the cleaning. So let's take
$1,000 there,
just in the refrigerant. So let's take a look at the condition of the indoor unit, and then we'll weigh the options: replacement versus, you know, patching this thing back together.
Replacement of what? Of the outside and inside units.
Yep.
Like what do they use now instead of Freon?
410A. So let's go see that, okay, and then we'll go from there.
And this we're not going to address until something happens.
Yeah, this one here that I'm sitting on top of, yeah, it's old Lennox. No, not yet. It's old Lennox, also a two-ton system. Again, you know, see, they're the original with the development. You know, some people, most people still have them.
Yeah.
And some don't. They've been replaced already.
So two.
You know, like Mossberg.
$225 a ton? I mean, a pound?
For R22, yes.
So what does that come to? How many pounds do you think they need?
Yeah, probably going to go through about 4 pounds here.
4 pounds, that's a thousand.
Yeah. Plus maybe adding a sealant, plus the labor, plus the cleaning of the coil. So that's why I said, let's go check out the condition of the indoor unit. If it's probably the original Lennox, which is under the stairs, we'll get to it from the, because the one in the garage, that's for the first floor.
I'll show you one second. It's not quite. And leave this still running?
Yep. Yeah, it is. Very nice. Kitchens are usually in the back.
Yeah.
So here.
No, here, it's in the back.
It's not in here?
No.
Oh, you moved it.
No,
oh.
This is how I bought it. Here's for the first floor. That's first floor. Hold on. That's first floor.
All
second
right. Second
floor's over here.
Let's look at the second floor.
Second floor is here. These, I don't know if they're working.
The humidifiers, yeah, I hear you. So that's the first floor filter.
And I vacuum them every 2 weeks.
And the filter for the second floor is...
to go in there.
When's the last time you changed that?
And then in there. Change it? About 2 months ago.
Okay.
But I vacuum these, seriously, with a vacuum. What do I have to, you know, here it's the... This was Schwartz. This is, what's her name? Deborah Schwartz's house. That's her son.
Oh, okay. So,
you know Gluck, you know Ivan and Phyllis Gluck? They own this for the kids, and the girl was going through a divorce.
So, Lenny, you have two choices.
Yeah. Okay.
Option number one. We replace the equipment. And that's furnace.
That's this.
The furnace, the evaporator coil. Yeah,
okay.
And we replace the outdoor unit and the copper lines that connect the two together.
Okay.
And depending on what brand and what models we can obtain for you, because everything is very limited to get right now, it will justify the price. But realistically, you could spend, you know, $12,000 to $17,000 installed.
For one
system.
For half the house.
Yes. Alternatively,
$12,000 to $17,000.
Yes, welcome to 2020. It's called Bidenflation.
Yeah, but that's okay. You know what these units cost 5 years ago? Could they have gone up triple or what?
Prices have skyrocketed. Wow. There's a reason why inflation is double digits now. So realistically,
that's a big spend.
Well, because you have builder's grade on the low end,
right,
and you have like the Rolls Royce, which is ultra efficient, and you know, there's a heat pump. It does both, you know, gas heating and heating by means of heat pump action.
Which is what we have.
No, you have a gas furnace with just traditional split AC. So gas heating is the only source of heat.
Air conditioning is never on a gas system. Air conditioning, the heat part is, but not the cooling.
Yeah, but the cooling, you reverse the air conditioning cycle and you provide heating for the winter months.
Okay.
And you can actually, if you really want to be efficient here, you could do a dual fuel setup where you have the heat pump will be the primary source of heat because it's that efficient during mild winter days. And on X amount of temperature outside, the gas furnace will kick on, and that will be your primary source of heat. It's actually very, very efficient.
But you get, you know, but that's on the higher end of that spectrum, that pricing spectrum.
So that's about 17.
Yeah, and that would be a Bosch like system.
But even if I get something that's a $12,000 system, if it doesn't have the fancy bells and whistles, but it's a good system, you know.
Well, it's builder's grade.
Okay.
It's like a car. A Hyundai is still going to get you from point A to point B, the same way a Rolls Royce will, right? Or a Ferrari. They'll still get you from point A to point B. It depends on the style and how you get delivered there. So on the low end, I can get you a builder's grade system. Again, it's based on availability. Let's say you say, Mike, you know what? Find me something for $12,000. You may wait maybe a month or two for that equipment to all come in.
What kind of a job is this? I wouldn't want to be out of air conditioning during the summer.
Well, you're out of air conditioning now. Huh? You're out of air conditioning now.
Well, not really.
The second floor doesn't cool.
No, the second floor does cool. Okay, you shut the windows, you turn it on very early
because,
in the morning.
Because you have the first floor is also working. You have that open like staircase, and hot air does rise up there. And the pressures that are in the system, it's not extracting heat from the air, from the inside of the house. Air conditioning does two things. Extracts heat from the indoor climate controlled area and removes humidity. Okay. It's not extracting any heat right now. You feel the fan, the air on top of that unit while it's running, it's ambient temperature air. If you turn on the first floor, you're gonna feel that when it's hot.
So let's say we're somewhere at 14,000.
Okay.
I don't know.
Okay.
I'll get you somewhere
in that price range, 14 to 15, I can get you like a carrier, a 2-ton carrier with a new gas furnace. And
if I said I want a 2.5-ton carrier?
We would have to do a load calculation.
Okay.
All right. So if you're gonna go out, because I know this development, I know what each floor needs. It's 2 tons per floor, right? So I know that unless you know the insulation value has changed, has been increased, the windows have been changed, and has increased, there's more insulating value on the windows.
You know, we got the old shit.
The envelope. So if the envelope has changed, then we can probably go to 1.5 tons. Right, but I know
that we're going to need 2.5. That's my best guess. We've been here 5 years.
Well, for comfort, yes, right. But it's not, the house doesn't need that.
Okay.
Yeah. So let's say a 2.5-ton system. There's not much of a price difference between the 2 and 2.5. It's insignificant. If we're going to 2 to 3, yes, then we're talking about a jump in pricing. But for somewhere in that price range, in the middle of the road, I can get you like a Carrier, or maybe a Bryant, which is made by Carrier.
So that's a $14,000.
That's a 14-15 in that range.
And that's pulling out zone 2.
Yep, taking out the furnace.
Everything having to do with zone 2.
With the exception of the ductwork.
Oh, the ductwork is there.
Exactly.
Okay.
So we take out the equipment, we take out the line set, and we replace that with new. You have a new outdoor unit.
Zone 1 stays, it can always be replaced.
Correct.
Not going anywhere.
Well, we were talking about the second floor right now.
Okay.
Yes. So let's weigh that. So now we have, let's say, 15 versus... let's say 2. Let's just say 2. 2,000. Right? We have $1,000 in refrigerant. Right. If you want to add the sealant to try to maybe seal up the leak, that's another $200. I'm rounding up now.
When you say leak?
Sealant. There's a leak in the system.
Okay. Whatever.
A refrigerant leak. Not a water leak, a refrigerant leak. So now we have, so that's $1,200. Now we have cleaning and disassembly and putting all that back together. We have another couple hours of labor. That's add, I'm rounding up, $500. So that's $1,700 plus tax. There you go. You're a little under $2,000. And that's a gamble.
$1,000. It's a gamble.
It's a gamble. Huh? Versus 15. That, and that, those are realistic numbers.
But with the twelve, fourteen, or fifteen thousand, whatever, with that system,
you're getting a brand new system that's going to be guaranteed for a minimum of 10 years by the manufacturer, and we'll offer a 2-year warranty on that, as long as. After year one, you call us and we do maintenance, right, which is included.
The $2,000 system is basically...
a I'm going to clean... Because that outdoor unit, that coil in the outdoor unit is wearing a fur coat. It really is. There is no heat transfer. Yeah. If we go that route and I take that unit apart, you're going to see fur on all four sides of that coil. And fur is interfering with heat transfer. So it's not working. So even if I add the refrigerant... I mean, like, listen, I'm not going to take your money unless we clean it.
No, but Mike, how could we lose on the deal? We get a season or two or three. I don't know.
Okay, so it could leak out next week, next month, next year.
Right.
Unknown. I don't know. I've never been here to service the air conditioner.
Would there
before.
Be any kind of guarantee or warranty?
Absolutely nothing.
Nothing
you
at
actually,
all.
And you actually sign a form that states that I told you all these options.
But
the options are.
Will there be a guarantee on at least the?
No, there's no guarantee whatsoever. You're gonna if you go that route. I'm gonna be making you aware of five options. Option number one, you do nothing. Option number two, we add the refrigerant as needed.
Hold on.
Option number three, we add the refrigerant, we add the sealant with the dye. Option number four, we look for the leak, which is not an option because the system is old. Option number five, you replace the system. So, and you're gonna sign a form because there's more lawyers out there than there are people like me.
I know what you're talking about.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, you heard me interact with the homeowner client, and I firmly believe in this rule. There is no pressure. I'm not a high pressure salesman. When you have to make a decision as substantial as that, a repair that won't be guaranteed versus a new system, and you even heard me mention the pricing, because I don't like to talk about pricing on this channel, strictly because every geographic area, every demographic area is different. What I could charge here may not be the same in West Bumblefuck, you know, Middle America, right? I'm not saying people live in Middle America or live in West Bumblefuck, but you know what I mean, right? If you're living in the middle of the country, obviously overhead and pricing and things like that and cost of living are different. But you heard me give two options. We have on the low side, a couple thousand versus many, many thousands, you know? And I'm not gonna pressure them into making a decision. Let me collect my trip charge, my hour of labor, and we'll go from there. Take the time to make a decision. And when we left, I did not catch it on video, but they're not wanting to go the gas and go with the sealant. They are contemplating which system they're gonna go with. Do they want a builder's grade system or do they want the high-end system? And the builder's grade, I can get them like a Ruud, a Ream, right? A 2.5, 2-ton system, you know, the furnace, the evaporator coil, 80%er. You know, middle of the road, I get them a Carrier. High-end, a Bosch. Set that up for dual fuel. Put an EcoBee thermostat in there. Have a nice day. Let me get your thoughts and feedback down in the comment section down below, guys. Did I handle this correctly? And if I didn't, how would you have done things differently? Thanks so much for watching. I'll catch you in the next one. Be well. God bless. Stay safe.